the game stragglers. Does anybody, did everybody get a copy of this? Everybody? Yes? Okay. What we did is after you all decided in the last workshop to adopt the goals out of the community vision plan, we went ahead and made all of the revisions of the document from the last meeting. We also emailed it out, and they're all in here. And then we also went ahead and took all of the policy statements and issues as they were listed in the community vision plan and incorporated them in here. And you will see them in blue. So, and the reason we reprinted, not the entire document, but if anybody would like a new document, we'll take a show of hands and we'll print one out. So this is completely reorganized. The goals are now the goals from the community vision, as was suggested the last time, and then the issues and opportunities were reorganized so that they follow the order of the goals as they are listed now in the comp plan. And then under the issues and opportunities, we have the ones out of the community vision as well, alongside the ones that we discussed at the last meeting. So what we kind of need to do is go through these issues and opportunities again, because A, the order has changed, and B, we have added quite a few out of the community vision. So you can just go through and you know, decide which ones to keep, if you want to keep them all or if you want to reword them. And then we go through in your, if you have the big document, the policy section has also changed, because we have included also anything that resembles a policy statement out of the community vision plan into here. But that will change again between this meeting and next, depending on the issues and opportunities. So we did not print that out for everybody. But you will get updated sections as we go along. So if you want to go, we have quite a few left people on last time.
I have a question. If I understand correctly from the last time, there's not any harm in having, say, 10 goals, because if you have 10 things and then you want to apply for a grant, you have something that's already in your plan that you can say, well, this is what it's supporting.
Right.
But if we were to pare this down and say, throw out intergovernmental coordination, and then there was a place for us to do something with that, we couldn't actually fit it in. So it's better for us to have more rather than less. Is that correct?
Yeah, and there are some core elements, and you know, economic development, housing, land use, natural cultural resources, community facilities, and intergovernmental coordination. Those are the core elements that DCA is actually looking for, and then the others are at the discretion of the local governments. But it's your comprehensive plan. So if you want community wellness and education and transportation separate from community facilities, that just reflects your priorities. So that's certainly the way to go. So we also revised the revision, the vision based on last workshop's comments. We used a shorter one out of the community vision, and then expanded it a little bit with explanations from the vision that was originally in the comp plan. And I think the consensus was that the last couple sentences were kind of what you all wanted to have in there. So if you want to take a quick peek at the community vision as it's there now, and see if that does everybody know each other here? Do we need to, should we go around real quick now that we don't have that many people? And, you want to start?
I'm Mariel Goggin with the Regional Commission.
Joyce Evans, Lansdowne Board of Commissioners.
Jason Danborn, Lansdowne County Planner.
Andrew Smith, I'm just a citizen of Austria. Pam Summers, Moody Air Force Base.
Derek Burt, Moody Air Force Base.
Jack Mindell, citizen, but also attorney. Doug Miller, Harrison Mindell.
Gretchen Portman, community activist.
Jessica Freeman, City of Remington, probation officer slash planning and zoning.
G.R. Hoax, I'm City of Dasher.
Ron Omero, Fairgrass, thank you for coming.
Vivian Mary McCarty, City Councilwoman, District 1.
And I'm Julia Plano for Southern Georgia Regional Commission. Okay, so now that we know, we have a really good variety of beer. So if you want to just take a quick look at the vision and see if it meets your expectations. So.
I would say that it pretty well reflects what we talked about the last time, you know, with a short introductory sentence that people could actually learn, and then the supporting information afterwards.
Yeah, I like how you tried to just shorten up the really long last vision but still incorporate that on the community at the very top.
Okay. Sounds good. And again, you know, if you have anything that you would like to change or add or delete, this can be done all the way up to transmittal, and then you have to wait for DCA comments to come back before we can make any more revisions. But okay, next to the community goals. So these are the ones out of your community vision. So we the newly adopted ones from what, 2014?
2009. Oh,
the vision.
Mm-hmm. 2014.
Yeah. Yeah. So these are the new goals. If you just take a quick look at them, make sure you're still happy with them, and then we'll move into the policies, into the issues.
Under community wellness, does that also include like law enforcement when we apply for grants and fire?
That can be two places. That can be either under community wellness, and traditionally if you don't have the community wellness, it's also under community facilities, which is actually community facilities and services. So it can be both places.
Should the word services then be somewhere in facilities?
Yeah, it should be right behind facilities, yes. So it can be in either one of those places. Comments on the goals? All right, moving on. So the issues and opportunities from last time are now reorganized so that they match the order of the goals. The ones in black are the ones that we talked about the last time, including the revisions from last time. And the ones in blue are the ones we haven't talked about yet. Those are the ones out of the community vision. So if you want to start with economic development, just look over the black ones. Make sure we got all your comments correctly, and then let's go over the blue ones. And actually, what I would like to see are some complete sentences there. And I know So it helps us to explain to DCA, you know, what is the intention behind this issue statement, what really is the issue. For example, improvements at the airport, what is the issue that resulted in this statement? this would be a comment that we would get back from DCA. Some of them are, yeah.
Just a step back, sorry, because I read slowly apparently. But on the economic development on the goal, the third line down, to meet the needs of expanding local, is there local economy? Local.
There's a word missing.
I think just local, was it meant local economy?
I think yeah.
Okay.
Check
doesn't
pick
those up.
Oh, I know.
Economy.
I'm just in the economy.
Yeah.
I don't
know
if that was the intent or not.
Yeah, there's another typo on
the
education.
Yeah. Don't
worry about typos.
No.
It's not a typo, it's just missing a word. So
yeah,
that's honest job.
The goal for education is that it seems to sort of end rather abruptly.
Yeah.
Listed in the CCD as careers.
Yeah, it's okay. Careers.
Careers.
Is that right? Careers.
Got it. Okay.
So the first three in black, do you have any comments to those? Those are the ones from last workshop.
So somewhere we talked about tourism as a, was that in this section, economic development, when we talked about agritourism?
Yes.
Under opportunities. Okay, well, so one of the things here that says an issue, then farther down says need a downtown tourism booth open on the weekends. I'm actually familiar, I don't think I wrote that one in, but I'm familiar with this. Sometimes when we're at the farm days on the weekend and the farmer booths are there, people will come around and they'll say, So where's the information for your county? Because it's the weekend, they're maybe passing through, they found the farmer's market, but they need something else that's open on the weekend that could tell them what things are available. Because the Climate Center is closed on the weekend, and that's where our tourism authority is. So if there were something, now this is sort of like a little detail, but farther along we have the opportunity to have tourism and agritourism and, you know, outdoor things that we've been talking about. We maybe need to state that as an issue that we need to better support the tourism something.
Does Main Street still have a booth there when the farmer's market is?
Ish. So they were taking turns between Main Street and the health department. So somebody from Main Street wasn't necessarily always there. And Main Street only knows about things that happen sort of in the downtown. They don't have any information about Wild Adventures or about the 37 Trail or the 41 Trail or things like that. We really maybe need to have downtown. We need to better support our tourism aspects. So without saying any details, you know, about how we're going to do that, because we don't know what opportunity will come. But we do need to do that better, I think.
Like a welcome center.
Well, the issue is that our tourism authority is only open on the weekdays during business hours. That's the issue. And so we can address under opportunities maybe how to fix that. But the issue is that tourism and tourists are here on the weekend,
right,
and there's not a place for them. Yeah, that's the one I'm trying to address.
Okay.
That we need to do something about that. Because I have actually answered people, and then I've sadly sent them to say, hey, well, the Skillet Fest is over in the next county. Go over there for something great to do today. You know, and that's not what I want to tell people.
But to address that, that is only long-range planning on tourism.
Okay, well, then we need to have a place in here so that we can apply for grant money so tourism can get it.
So I guess we moved into the blue. The first two, I think, from what I've read, are already addressed by the first black issue. Those are kind of duplicates from in there. What about the third one, skilled workforce with soft skills needed?
Well, I think that goes in education, actually.
Yeah, what was the intent behind that statement?
Well, these came from random citizens, right, that filled in the survey?
To me, these look like, I'm not sure, did y'all get these from, like, the public comment statements of the CCB? Is that where these blue ones came from?
They came from the spreadsheet that Corey gave us with everything that went into the community vision.
Okay. These look like the public comments that came out of that. Like when they were seeking for public comment, there were, you know, these are the various public comments that came back. So that's where I think they're coming from, because they're not coming from the statements or the policies. They're actually coming from like the public comment section. So this is, you know, public comments from that last round, a series of public hearings.
Which is exactly where they need to go here with the issues and opportunities. But we don't need to include them all, that's why they're in blue.
Well, I think if you're talking about the workforce, like in education, the soft skills going to be picked up in that interview, it's going to affect the job and work in the workforce.
So is that something that should go, that statement, more into education?
Yes.
What about the next one? We are too reliant on blue-collar jobs.
Well, I think that's addressed in the first one. Issues of low wages and declining workforce. I think that's already taken care of.
All right, we'll take
same
care.
With the next one.
Same with the next one, the next two.
I didn't know this came from, so that's good to hear.
The next two can really go either in economic development or in education. We need an education system that's current and competitive, focused on the needs of this 21st century workforce.
That needs to go on education.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, and move that to education.
And so does the lack of student retention in there. Well, that's kind of hard to say because one of the things we do at BSU is when we shake our students' hands as we give them their diplomas and pat them on the back, heading them toward I-75. There's not really anything for our students here.
Yeah. I think that's also addressed in the first one that says many young professionals leave the area in search of greater opportunities. So
I'd say you've got that one.
Yeah, I think you've got that covered.
Got that one covered. Basic infrastructure components, broadband, public transit needed for economic development are not in place.
Okay, well, I would say that the broadband part of that is true. We've had businesses try to locate here and then move to Thomasville because the internet here was insufficient. And, you know, there's chronic complaints about people that, you know, can't afford to have the internet at home, and then if their children have to do schoolwork that's internet-based, they end up at the library, then we get to the part where we have a crummy library. So I think that certainly an issue here in terms of economic development is we're never going to attract any sort of high-tech company that needs access to the internet, because while they say, oh, but we have fiber and it runs right down by the railroad track, okay, getting hooked onto that fiber that runs right by the railroad track isn't really practical. So we need a practical implementation of that.
Jason, do you know if that Lake Park Outlet Mall, is that still without internet?
I don't know. I thought they have internet. I just thought they had complaints about speed, but I'm not sure.
I continue to hear from people in Lake Park that if they give their internet up, they can't get it back. So there's such a limited amount of, so there's a plug for each connection. And if you give yours up, somebody else takes it. And then you have to get way back at the back of the line. Well, how can you have, say people wanted to telecommute and you were going to get some company that says you can work from home, but people can't get the internet where they choose to live. I mean, we're not going to attract anybody with that. So having good internet access here, I think, is really important.
Yeah, or even we have that outlet. You know.
Yeah.
I mean, without internet, that's...
Yeah, to turn it into a business park instead. Well,
Yeah, right.
I think it's an issue not only for economic development, but in the community facilities and services. Mm-hmm. You probably have some duplication.
Yeah,
right. Mm-hmm. Maybe helpful to just keep it in both, but...
Right,
I think you have two aspects.
Well, and whichever one is the infrastructure one. Yeah.
Yeah.
So is the public transit there?
No, that just needs to be.
Okay.
That's transportation.
So we'll definitely.
But there is an economic development component to transportation. Mm-hmm. Because if people can't get to work reliably, then companies have a problem.
So it needs to be in both.
Okay. Maybe we'll just separate these two to make sure.
Well, the bottom, you've got a public transportation that says needed, so just highlight it there.
So there's two. Okay. And I think the next one, affordable internet, that goes right into.
Right. Like Jason said, if these were just like, you know, 20 people typed in something, there was going to be duplication.
Sure. Right. The next one, dependence on Moody Air Force Base, loss of Moody Air Force Base would be devastating. We do address that in opportunities, but we did not have an issue for that. So, is that an issue that we want to? Do you look at it as an issue, or just as an opportunity? Because we do list them in opportunities. That it is an engine. That's one of the economic engines.
Could just put, you know, the support of, the support of Moody Air Force Base and, you know, their economic challenges and growth opportunities they have, something like that.
Well, or we could look at that and to say sort of what is the major industry that supports our community, and it's the government. So we have Moody, we have BSU, we have Wiregrass, we have the hospital, we have the public schools, we have the public government. That probably is the majority of people work for some government organization. don't know if that's an issue, but it's probably a fact.
So maybe greater diversity of job opportunities needed?
Yeah. Well, and then, you know, all of those government things aren't going to all go under all at once.
Right.
But you, if Moody were to leave us, we'd have less students in our schools, and we'd have less money for the government, and we'd have, and it wouldn't make a big change.
The next three, I think, are kind of together. Need a set of competitive incentives to bring in industry.
I could fall under the industrial authority. Yeah, help with the growth of the industrial authority.
I mean, is that a true statement, though? Is there a lack of?
I don't think so. I think that the industrial authorities. Thank you.
I haven't heard that as an issue.
Okay.
About us lacking some incentives to bring companies in.
And let's take that out. Next one, need more community-wide economic development efforts. And
what does that mean?
From what I can read, that there are not enough community-wide economic development efforts.
That's the strength of having the development authority, though, is there.
Yeah. And now we're
body,
but that was like years ago, so I think in the meantime, that has probably changed.
Didn't the Development Authority just commission a big study about the workforce here?
Mm-hmm. A couple of years ago. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Has that been involved in this process?
I bet
if you could look at that study,
yeah,
you'd see a lot to add.
Yeah.
Do you know if it's done, Jack, or they just started that?
No, I think it's done.
No, it's done.
Done.
This is the one they did with Georgia Power sponsor.
Okay. It was in the newspaper about 6 months ago,
yeah,
I guess. Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure that that's done, and they talked about, they had focus groups and everything, and people came in and talked about different stuff.
Mm-hmm. They did. They interviewed several different mm-hmm. local businesses, and Brian interviews, he's asked what their impressions of the community were.
Okay,
you could probably get some good feedback.
Yeah.
A lot of people who know.
Yeah, we probably should add that in an appendix to the comp plan too. Would you write that down? Cool. Need more community involvement?
Probably under community wellness, maybe.
No, communication. I think that community involvement goes under communication. When people feel like they're being communicated with, then they are inclined to be involved.
I think it's in here. I just think it's somewhere. I don't think it's cultural.
It could be intergovernmental coordination.
Sure.
We'll look at it. Okay. Waste treatment for heavy industry needed.
The industry. Oh, I didn't write this one either, but I do know some. Some of our heavy industries that are in the industrial parks. Have their wastewater treated through the Mud Creek water treatment plant at Valdosta. And that wastewater treatment plant does not have the, it's designed for residential waste, not commercial waste. So what maybe goes out of there might not be appropriate to be going into the Mud Creek. I think that that's the concern about that. That do we know that the waste from the industrial parks where, you know, we don't know whether they're throwing paint down the drain. We have no idea. And then it goes over to Mud Creek. Is Mud Creek sufficient to handle that?
Not just Mud Creek. How about the new facility?
Yeah, how about the new facility? Exactly. You know, if we're going to be inviting industries here, do we have the right resources to be able to handle the waste that comes out of those industrial resources?
Are we competitive with the surrounding communities?
Right. Or peer
communities.
We have peer what communities.
Thomasville has, or Tipton has.
Right.
Yeah. I know they have a program. John Waite, I think is his name. But he works for the city, and I know that's what part of his job is figuring out, okay, you need a special permit to discharge XYZ into the treatment system.
Right.
Which venture out. I don't know how much of a that is, but that's not, I'm not sure. I mean, that's city utilities.
Yeah. Okay.
So is the next statement more what's needed rather than this waste treatment? It looks like these two are
right.
Not the same, but the second one is the more appropriate in terms of economic development.
Well, capacity is one thing. So if we build more houses and we build more people that are flushing the toilet in business and the university, that's capacity. But being able to deal with what comes out of industry is a different thing.
These are completely different issues.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it doesn't say, in the second statement, it doesn't say anything about domestic water rather than industrial. It just says increased capacity.
Right. Well, capacity is volume. And the process, we need both volume and the correct process for industry.
Okay, so maybe just get rid of the first one and add capacity and process.
Probably community facilities and services.
Yeah, yeah, move that to community facilities and services,
but
and we can combine
okay.
The two. That we'll make sure that it's in there.
And one of the reasons why I'm sensitive to this is, you know, because we've had wastewater going down to Florida, and, you know, our Florida friends are not happy with us, and then if we're sending stuff down both the rivers, you know, they're going to be really unhappy with us. And with the whole big problem with, I don't know if you all heard about this, that Waycross has radioactive material in their drinking water now.
Oh,
we
no.
Do not want that happening here.
Mm-hmm.
No, I haven't heard that yet.
Yeah.
That's the truth. Okay, so we'll move that community to the community facilities and services,
okay.
And we'll combine them and
make
sure both of these are.
There.
Yeah, yeah, we'll make sure that those are addressed. Improve the business development process. I think that's handled through the development authority.
I think maybe what this is aimed at is, you know, like the chamber tries to partner with existing businesses to make sure that the rate is a suitable level versus not too overbearing. So I think that comment is maybe aimed at making sure the regulations are still a good balance between kind of public and private.
SORT committee.
Right. You know,
they could give
you
feedback.
So I don't think the business development process, I think it's, you know, almost like a permitting process. We hear some consistent, you know, making sure we don't have too many regulations or too few.
So that's really not so much an issue as an opportunity.
We've heard, some of the complaints I've heard is that, you know, if you have too many regulations and too long of a process, it'll be something that's a hurdle for business expansion and business attraction.
Okay.
It's kind of the issue I've heard when it's thrown out. Is
okay.
That could be something that's a hurdle.
Many local developers say that it's a hurdle. The LDR, the LDC. The SOAR committee, a lot of research on this.
Mm-hmm. What they do is they kind of ferret out the individual issue and figure out where it kind of balance out. But
okay.
That's the overall complaint is too many regulations, too long, too much time.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, we can reword that now that we know what's behind that. Improvements at the airport.
Oh, well, I think that's addressed by need for expanded air service, and the sentence there is pretty correct.
Okay. More support for DBE businesses and small businesses?
I mean, economic development or cultural, but
this,
we have heard that with some of the recent headlines about school systems and some of their contractors, and I know the city's taken some extra steps to include DBE businesses, but I can't tell you a pinpoint where I think this can come from.
Okay. Need more business incubators?
Mm-hmm. Chamber just got done with that study, kind of having a roadmap of a business, you know, future business incubator. So that wasn't in place until the last 2 months, really.
Okay.
Well, is there something though? If we're thinking about what would the government, if you will, the county or the city, when they're following the comp plan, the chamber, you know, wants to follow the comp plan in terms of, you know, making sure that their business support things are supporting this and that this is supporting where they want to take businesses. But I don't know, what would be, why would we have a business incubator program in the comp plan?
Just if it's a local economic development issue, and then you can have a policy that you would support a program, you know, development. That would be more of a policy,
a
rather
policy.
Than it would go into
okay.
the government
okay.
work program.
Okay, because I can think of another example.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm good.
I think the last study was, would one help the chamber work with, I thought it was Georgia Tech, and the consensus was, yes, we think an incubator would help your community. So the issue is we don't currently have one.
Right. Okay.
And I think they're on their way to trying to figure out how to partner and create one, you know, to help small business and
okay.
growing business to start that.
Can I go back to one of the others that we passed? We say no support for the DE business, and I think that's something, I think Jason just made a statement about what happened at the school system and others. I think that really needs to be addressed. I don't know whether we need to put in economic development or in some other area, but it's definitely one of the things that needs to be addressed.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely going to stay in as its own issue. That's good. Lack of local media, lack of a local TV station.
Did you just skip over
smart grid?
Oh, smart grid, that was under the, when we were up a little bit higher, basic infrastructure up there, broadband needed for economic development, that's kind of a duplicate.
No, it's grid usually means power, electric.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And are you aware that Southern Company just bought a smart grid company, which could be an opportunity for this area to, you know, hold up their hand and say, what if you try that out around here?
So is that an issue that we don't have a smart grid here?
Well, John, you probably should explain, you know, do you mean like smart grid like electric cars? Do you know what
sure.
that scope means?
Okay, the context that this came up in is a Southern Company is grappling with what to do about wind and solar power. Because they have the same concern of all utilities, they're used to baseload capacity power plants where you produce, you know, X amount of kilowatt hours for X amount of time, and so very dependable from these big, few plants. Naturally, with solar and wind, you have a lot of little generators that may be going up and down at various times. Thus, you need a grid that's smart enough to deal with energy coming in from various directions at different times and melding it all together. That's basically what the smart grid idea is about. And Valdosta, for example, has done some things to promote solar power, for example, with the solar panels that they have down at the other wastewater plant.
Mud Creek.
Mud Creek, yes. Mm-hmm. And they keep talking about perhaps adding more. And Georgia is now the fastest growing U.S. solar market. Mm-hmm. So an opportunity would be, as we all know, Georgia Power is very active, left in the Development Authority and the Chamber and so forth. An opportunity would be to see if Georgia Power would be interested in doing something similar to what they did with the LED lighting, where Valdosta is one of the first cities that's got the LED street lights. Perhaps they would be interested in doing, trying out some of their smart grid opportunities and solar installations here, which would be something that might look very forward thinking to businesses, such as the kind that everyone's trying to attract. Is that convey the idea?
Yeah. I just want to make sure everybody knew that it was more about alternative forms of energy and how you manage those.
Renewable. Fossil fuels are now the alternative. Huh. There are more jobs as of 2015 in the solar industry than in all of oil and gas extraction, according to the U.S. government.
Wow.
Okay. So that would be, would have a place here as well as in community facilities and services. So we'll make sure we have it in both. Because one, it could act as an attractor for employment and industries that are in that same mode of thinking.
Well, and the other thing is our community is large enough to be a good test area, but small enough that
right.
You know, didn't work exactly the way they thought. It would be
right.
Horrible.
Okay. Okay, next one then, local media, lack of local TV station.
I don't know, I don't feel like we get awful coverage from, you know, I thought we had at least two local outlets, if not three, when you include Valdosta with their own news crew and channel, so maybe I'm missing something. Maybe I don't watch the news as much as I should, but we have at least two local, you know, satellite offices from Tallahassee that,
and Albany.
Yeah.
And Albany, WLP.
Yeah, and Albany. I don't know.
So it's really, is everybody agreeing that there's really not an issue anymore?
I think the only issue is TV and newspapers are so scrappy these days, there's lots of things they just don't cover. But if the existing stations can't do it, who can make up a business model to make a local one that can do it?
Right.
Okay. The next one, public transportation needed, we talked about that earlier, to get people to work reliably and affordably.
Right.
Yeah, okay.
They're doing studies on that need right now. To me, it's not about whether people will use it, it's whether or not it's worth the expense to implement it.
Same question could be raised for every road or bridge.
Sure, but they don't run you quite as large of a deficit every year, maybe.
How much did that bridge on State Road cost?
I don't know.
I think it was about $15 million. When will it be paid back?
I didn't notice the toll booth there. You put diamond crossover.
All right, next one. Need more promotion of rural businesses and job opportunities.
We talked about a little bit last time about, you know, that agriculture is a big industry here, and we don't really talk about it when we're talking about what are our industries, and we don't say, hey, you know, we have these, and it's part of what gives us the community feel that we have, is that we are an agricultural community. And we do have a variety of jobs where, you know, like, if you like to work outside, there's a lot of jobs for you here where you can work outside. So, you know, we should focus on that.
Right. Yeah, that's something that came up last time for sure. Need more general tourism?
I think that goes with the one that we already talked about.
The downtown tourism.
The downtown tourism that we need to support tourism there.
If I could put in a plug, as World's Watershed Coalition for a comprehensive plan currently has in it the idea of blueways, which are...
I think that goes in lifestyle.
Yeah,
does it?
Yeah.
Natural resources.
Both. And
yeah.
And community wellness. There's a place for those.
So it's tourism right there. And that would attract more tourism. It already is. Walls is already reprinting the Lapa River Water Trail brochure. 35,000 have already gone out.
You know, the tourism just completed some research and information about tourism here, so it could be a problem.
Oh, and Lowndes County is paying for a boat ramp on the Lapa River using SWALST funds. So.
Right.
Well, that's definitely natural resources and community dollars. Yeah, we have, from last meeting, under opportunities, we did address the agritourism and ecotourism, but they should definitely be expanded.
All right.
And then the last one for blue ones is large manufacturing sites do not have public water and sewer, few to no sites with existing water and sewer.
I don't know if that's true.
Yes.
You would need the industrial authority to answer that, but I don't think that that's necessarily true.
No. This doesn't sound right to me, Julie. I don't know what it's called.
So the question is really more, you know, does the treatment facility have the capacity and capability to handle what comes out?
Right.
Not necessarily how it gets there.
Right.
Okay. Opportunities under economic development. The ones in black, again, are the ones that we talked about at the last meeting, and these include the revisions and comments from last meeting. So if you want to look at those real quick and make sure that we got your comments reflected in here the way you wanted them to, and then we'll go over the blue ones.
Number two doesn't seem to be about agriculture. Still one of the biggest economic engines in the county.
To add agriculture to that second bullet point?
I mean, Julie, do you think that's appropriate? I mean, I think there's certainly a main regional economic engine. They just don't have
a name to it,
you know,
an institution.
You could certainly call silviculture an agricultural engine, but you just don't have one company. You have several large companies, one main one.
Well, we can make it its own bullet point in all support of agriculture / silviculture.
I just don't know. There's a farm gate table where they list out, here's the value of, you know, the top 10 agricultural industries in Valdosta and Niles. I just don't have that. But that's where you get it.
You probably find it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, and then here's the balance between, you know, we talked last time, how specific do we want to be? Do we want to name out specific things, or do we want to sort of name larger categories of things where we say, you know, and so all these things that we named here, South Georgia Medical, Valdosta State, Wiregrass Tech, including Air Force Base, their own government. So we're not saying anything about private industries here that we want to be supporting too. We've named a bunch of government things.
Overall goal for economic development, though, does get very broad. And one place that I was going to send a comment to Julian Ariel is that maybe we should list out supporting existing businesses as a way of economic development, because that's such a strong indicator. Rather than attracting new, you really support what you have first.
Exactly.
But that should cover that. And so these issues and opportunity, I think we do have some coverage for existing businesses under our economic development goal, which is a good thing. Existing private business sector is a good thing.
Well, but is there an opportunity that we should name out here for supporting existing local private industries, including agriculture?
Mm-hmm. Just to call it out?
Yeah.
Because if you don't, people think if you say industry or business, you mean everything except agriculture or forestry.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You know, forestry is a big thing.
Okay, we'll call it out as a separate bullet point.
And point number four, Georgia Grown Trail, actually it's not near Lowndes County because the Trail 41 is going to go through Lowndes County. 37 goes near, but 41.
It's through Hayhara, doesn't it? Oh, 41.
41.
Mm-hmm.
41 goes through Lowndes County.
Mm-hmm.
So I would just say the Georgia Grown Trail passes through rather than near.
Later in the same sentence, both Coochee River, Little River, and the Black River.
Right, we are bounded by three rivers.
And there's not only the Lapa River water trail, soon there'll be a Withapuchee and Little River water trail.
These can also be brought up again in community right. wellness and in natural resources, where that can actually be expanded in a little bit more detail.
Right.
Yeah.
And then when we want to spend money to fix up the boat ramps that need improvement, we'll have a place to do it. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, drill down.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
So what happened to the welcome center on 75?
It's getting improved right now.
Looks like it's going to reopen.
Going down to Lake Park?
Yeah.
So that's good thing.
Recently we heard a talk about gateways. Tim Golden talked about gateways during his talk at the Rotary the other day, and how the Department of Transportation is allocating more money for the gateways, especially the ones that are being rebuilt at 2 and 22.
You want to specifically call these out here, or
no? I just
okay.
think that that's
that was
something
just a
that
comment.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just the improved gateways.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that those are there pretty well reflect what we talked about last time.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's move on to the opportunities listed in. Blue. Some of them, again, are very short, and I think we probably covered some of them, but create a regional database of sites and data relating to available land and resources.
Can we just stop just for a second?
Yeah.
We spent 2 hours, the last time we were here, we got through the vision statement, and two of these, I think we got through, because we made this, the items we have here, and we did... Which other one did we do?
We had natural cultural resources.
We started.
Yeah, we
started.
We did cultural resources and started on natural resources.
Well,
and we did housing.
Yeah, housing was the other one we
yeah.
did. So we did this one in housing. Well, now we've spent an hour, and we've only looked at half of them.
Well,
I'm just worried that, you know, we'll never get to the ones that are at the end. We'll never get to... last one, intergovernmental coordination. We'll never get there.
Well, we'll take the time we need to go through these because this is the meat of your comp plan. Because from here, you get into the policies and then you get into the work program. And those are the three core elements of your comp plan. So the time you spent on this now, while it's pretty tedious, it really follows very easily then into the other elements. Because what we discuss here goes into the next ones. I mean, you can go through it a little quicker if you want to, but you know we do need to go through them because this is where you're. This is the meat and bones.
I agree.
Yeah.
So we've spent an hour on one of these. We've got 10. That means we've got 10 hours ahead of us. We have 2 hours allocated for tonight. We haven't finished one item yet. That's all by only point.
Well, some of them will go quicker than
okay.
the others.
All right.
Can you schedule more workshops?
Yeah, we can schedule as many workshops as you want. That's...
Okay.
No, no. But the more input you have, the better compound you have. You know, this is, and you're not the only ones who are taking longer for the issues. Or opportunities.
Okay.
But once you get through these, it moves considerably faster. This is where your values are reflected. And this is what everything else comes out of.
Okay.
So, I mean, just read through these if you want to speed this up a little bit and, you know, see which ones do you want to keep.
What about create a regional database? Didn't the Development Authority already do that? Sites and data related to available land
for their own county, I don't know if we include other other counties, I'm not sure. I know we have a nice inventory of our own sites.
And this is really something that we can put in the regional comp plan, which we're updating right now at the same time. You know, it's just the annual update, not the full update. So let me just put that into the annual update of the regional plan. Take advantage of quality hotels and restaurants in the city, I guess city and county. Does that more in your tourism program? You know, and under excellent opportunities for tourism, we can put that under there. And the next two, we really already have covered in the regional engines.
So you're suggesting to get rid of them?
They're already addressed somewhere above.
Yeah, because they're already addressed under support of regional economic engine.
Just making sure.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to keep them, we'll keep them. I don't know. A great diversity of small businesses is listed as an opportunity. Do you agree with that? How about the encourage small business growth to increase revenue for the community? That would go right into the incubator that you're starting up. The next two really could be combined into one, and then tied right into the incubator and other efforts by the Chamber of Commerce.
The Great Promise Partnership.
Does anybody know what that is?
No.
I guess we'll do it.
The Great Promise Partnership?
Yes, ma'am.
I looked at a meeting that we had over at the Annex building, and that was something that the city had with the schools where they had young people, where they were bringing in and giving them opportunities to take like different classes of different things like that. It was, I think it's something with like higher education, and it was something the city had was providing and with the school.
Was it the program that the Development Authority was doing through with the schools where they came in and they had took a student out of the school and took them to the company to train them up so that they could then come in as an employee?
Something like that. Or they had these different companies, businesses that mentor the student and prepare them for different things like that.
I didn't know that that's the name of it.
I know they had the OSTA Early College Academy.
No, this was something with the Development Authority, where they had this matching up between companies who would take high school students who were sort of needing a little more guidance on how to get a job, be a job, be a worker, and then taking them and training them to be workers.
So how about we reword that a little bit to say continue programs such as the Great Promise Partnership and that. We'll include others. Okay. Good education, particularly higher education, is an opportunity for economic development.
Well, certainly the universities are an opportunity for higher education. And somebody said lately, you know, at Wiregrass, they're positioned in such a way that if a company came and said, you know, in 6 months we need people who can do X, they could make people that could do X. You know, we're positioned well there. We're just waiting.
And some of those could really be consolidated on, you know, and opportunities, we are a regional hub for higher education. We are. We're a regional hub for medical services. We have people who travel all over the region to use our medical services, same thing for higher ed, same thing for our economy. Is part of being a regional hub, that's an extreme opportunity for us.
I, for one, am very happy South Georgia Medical Center has Snake. Agricultural education needs to be a priority. I certainly agree with that. And I'm not recommending merging these, but I think it might be grouped with focus on local run products, perhaps even with programs to highlight small businesses. Because we actually have some things that help with all three of those. For example, we have one of only two ham and egg shows left in the entire country, which a number of our local business people go and buy the hams and eggs. And of course, we have South Georgia Growing Local, which draws a fair number of people. And we have this interesting startup that comes up Camden County, but their biggest location is in Valdosta, which is Dirt Road Organics, which is a new seller for locally grown and organic products. So we actually have a number of things popping up that promote all three of these things.
Okay. One of the things that I often imagined about the Lake Park empty strip mall, wouldn't it be really nice if that could be in some way remodeled to show off all of our agricultural and food prowess that we have here? If, you know, we could have cooking stores and, you know, that could be the location of a real farmer's market or something, you know. I think that there's an opportunity to really showcase the things that we do well here. Sort of a fantasy of mine that, you know, you could have something like that down there, that those buildings sit empty, and it would be nice to see them repurposed in something, somewhere.
With the internet.
With the internet, yes. I don't need too many internets for my vegetables, really.
Sure helps to sell them, though.
It does help to sell them.
It does help to sell them, yeah. Square.
And I know that, you know, industrial ag uses the internet, you know, GPS and all of that to locate themselves.
You had a farm to table cooking school. I mean, they probably.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. That's good. I mean, that's certainly an opportunity. I think Chamber of Commerce, the Seed Center, VSU, we can all incorporate into supportive regional economic engines and under. Promote such programs as Great Promise Partnership, Seed Center. Does that still exist?
Yes.
I'm not sure about the partnership with the Seed Center.
Yeah. But when we say continue programs and support programs such as, then, you know, that includes past and future. That type of program. Okay. Goodwill Career Center, would that fall into the same
chamber?
Yeah.
They're not
yeah.
the chamber, but I mean that's
well, the same
programs.
Kind of continued
programs
like.
Such as. Okay. So all three of those. Strong Development Authority.
Our opportunity there in terms of the Development Authority is they really changed their focus lately, like Jason said, from bringing companies in to supporting local industries and helping them to expand. So, you know, our opportunity is to expand local, you know, existing industries.
Okay. I think that's a worthwhile point to keep as an opportunity.
Also, most of the companies that they actually had a hand in bringing in are not located in numerous business parks. The one recently that has is Natural Mix, a natural food company.
Yeah, the honey company.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, developing downtown, transportation, all these other things we're talking about help the development party.
Okay. focus on local grown products as healthy foods in schools, restaurants, and markets. Okay, can I keep that?
Mm-hmm.
Programs to highlight small businesses as alternative to big box and national retailers. Opportunity that we want to keep in here.
Well, I think that that matches up with increased marketing about small business development resources,
mm-hmm.
because business development and, you know, the resources to develop your business, and then to have, you know, the support of those local businesses so that we're going to the local business that we, you know, let's take Natural Mates, for example. We bothered to bring Natural Mates in, and we're going to, now let's make an effort to buy that product that we make here.
The next three kind of are all in the same. Implement more smart and green technologies, alternative and renewable energy, energy efficient alterations to structures. Are these all, these are all opportunities that should be encouraged?
Mm-hmm. And they can be
leading right into
one.
Them.
Yeah, they, that
yeah.
could all be written into one thing.
Yeah.
They're all green initiatives.
Yeah.
Right.
Are y'all aware of the big legal change in Georgia this year related to all that? Georgia used to be one of only five states that said that you could only, you could not.
That was last year.
Last year, right. It's 2016 already. I keep forgetting that. In all but five states, you could have a company come in and say, I'm going to design a solar installation for your roof, and I'll install it, finance it, and you know, the company that does this will take the federal tax credit, and then you pay them, and you end up paying them less than you're paying for your energy bill until it's paid off, and everybody's happy with zero down in your pocket. That's possible in all but five states. Also related to that, in all but five states, you could put up your own solar panels. If you happen to have a big building, you could cover it with that and sell to your neighbors. In Georgia, you could not do that.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can. The four states remaining, the one most significant to us is Florida. Florida's going to have a referendum on its ballot, probably not this year, perhaps next time. But that's a big change, and it's something that we maybe could find a way to leverage locally. Because you know, the financing is the thing that's kept a number of people from doing solar power. Somebody has to put up the money up front. Local banks have not been willing to do it unless you put up collateral, by which they mean real estate, basically a second mortgage. So if there were some organization, oh, let's just say off the cuff, the Development Authority, that wanted to put up a fund for this sort of thing, that would greatly encourage local solar growth. And, you know, even without that, that's a huge change in the law in Georgia, which is one reason that Georgia is now the fastest growing U.S. solar market.
Cool. All right, the next, I think we already addressed that the county's becoming more diversified. More promotion of regional events. I don't know that that really needs to, that can go in the regional plan rather than in the local comprehensive plan.
This I think we addressed in other places.
Yeah. I think all of these, the last four are have already been addressed.
Is that digital economy plan? Is that set to be kind of regularly updated?
No, that was a one-time. That was a one-time thing.
Could it be regularly updated?
It could be regularly updated if we had funds.
Well, or could we include it in, you know, as we're talking about other, including other things as reference material? Could we include that as reference material?
Yep, sure.
What sort of funding would it take to regularly update it?
Well, it came from the state, so it would be funding through the CEO.
Unless or the local governments
unless the local governments decide to fund it.
perhaps if SRB, SCRB really amounts, who knows?
Well, and so that would be a thing that we could put under intergovernmental coordination, is to, you know, think about if we wanted to have the digital economy plan updated every,
I don't know,
5 years, then that could be done by the regional government. So it's a coordination rather than saying it came from the state.
Right. Yep.
Can someone explain the first bullet item?
Well, I'll explain what, you maybe missed this part of the meeting. These were, anything in blue is stuff we haven't discussed, and it came as citizen comments on the
Common Community
Vision, where it was a forum where people could just write in anything. So we haven't written out any sentences that say, what are the issues in education? Or any issues that are any opportunities. This we're starting to throw on a blank sheet of paper.
Mm-hmm. Well, on that particular topic, two things. Personally, I thought that was the case until I went to research and discovered that merging two school systems like this in general.